and gentlemen, welcome to the 2019 AutoTrader South African Car of the Year competition. Now, my name is Nhlakanipho Manqele. Yes, I know, it's a mouthful. But you can call me Neeps. N-E-E-P-S, right? That should be easy for you guys. Now, I will be your trusted host with the most and a toast for this evening. Now, what a beautiful setting and a fitting venue for the most prestigious motoring event in South Africa. Now, I'm sure all of you will agree that this year, things have definitely been done slightly differently. Now, a round of applause for this awesome super venue. I'm sure you'll agree, it's beautiful, stunning indeed. Now, before we kick off proceedings, there are a few house rules that I need to make you all aware of. Bathrooms can be located or can be found located to the right. Just pop around the corner and walk under the archway. A sign has been provided for guidance. Now, gentlemen, we know that trees can be used as lavatories, but not tonight, please. We beg you. Okay, thank you. Now, there are three bars located in the venue should you wish to get your own drinks this evening. Now, the main bar is located just through the glass doors over there. The second bar is located under the glass marquee, all right? And a gin bar located there at the back to my left, where you can mix the gin of your dreams and let the night go on. Now, we also have waiters and waitresses that will be at your service this evening. All alcohol is on the house. But should you want to celebrate with shooters, unfortunately, those will be on your own account. Okay. As this is a non-smoking venue, there will be, however, a designated smoking area right there on my left. Some people have been using it already. And this does include vapes and e-cigarettes, please. Okay. Now, in case of an emergency, all guests are to please make their way out of the venue in an orderly fashion. Right? The emergency assembly point is at the gravel car park where you initially entered the venue. But, however, we will assist you to get to safety during this process. Now, as you are aware, we are running a shuttle service this evening. Now, all shuttles will be on standby for the duration of the event to take you back to your cars at Huddle Park. Now, the shuttle pickup point is located at the end of the red carpet where you were dropped off earlier this evening. All right. While that takes care of the house rules, let's move on to the fun part. Okay, trending on this evening's digital theme, we encourage your participation. Now, if you want to tweet, Insta, or post on the Facebook, please make sure you use the hashtag AutoTraderCoty2019. Hashtag AutoTraderCoty2019. And follow at AutoTraderSA. Follow at AutoTraderSA. Our handles are the same across all social media platforms. Now, should you wish to use the Wi-Fi network this evening, please connect to TP-Link 2.4. TP-Link 2.4, and the password is shepping, all lower cases, and spelled S-H-E-P-P-I-E-G, shepping. Okay. Now, please take note, this is only extended to the glass marquee area. Unfortunately, for those who enjoy tweeting in the lavatories, we're sorry. Now, should you require any assistance, please don't hesitate to ask one of our friendly young members of the audience. I'm sure they will help you, elderly or senior members, should you need any help. Now, I have a special note right here. Oh, it's not in my pocket. Okay, but I remember it because I read it earlier on. It says, Roger, if you are on your phone, we all know you are playing Snake and are not interacting with social media. Roger? You got that right. Okay. Now, we will be doing a live stream of the event on our YouTube channel, which can be viewed on at AutoTraderSA on YouTube. And we ask that you please switch your phones to silent so that we avoid any disturbances or interruptions during the evening's proceedings. Ladies and gentlemen, sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. The inaugural AutoTrader South African Car of the Year Awards is live. All right, good evening and welcome to our AutoTrader SA YouTube viewers. For those of you who couldn't be here with us this evening, a big welcome to the 2019 AutoTrader South African Car of the Year competition. Now stay tuned as we bring you all of the action right here on the YouTube channel. All right. So, why are we here? Analyzing 12 cars from widely diverging categories and price brackets to define which one is the best takes some doing. But now this is what the 2019 AutoTrader South African Car of the Year competition is all about. Hauling huge speeds up towards Leeuwenkorp Corner at Kyalami, searching for your breaking point so that you can fling the car towards the apex and hopefully exit with enough track in hand without breaking off of the throttle. Now, all the while you are doing this, you are marveling at the amount of grip a standard road-legal machine offers up in today's motoring climate. Sounds like fun? Oh, yes. But the reason the 24 scribes were pounding around Kyalami on March 11, in a clockwise direction, by the way, was to assess the 12 finalists of the 2019 AutoTrader South African Car of the Year competition. Those 12 finalists would also be put through braking and handling tests at the Kyalami skid pan and the ultra-tight ride and handling track. The following day, the vehicles were assessed on their on-road abilities in a more relaxed, contemplative environment, giving jurors a chance to explore subtle nuances like rough road ability, cabin ambiance, practicality, infotainment capability, and much, much more. But please, do not take my word for it. Take a look at this. Alfa Romeo Stelvio. This first SUV from Alfa Romeo embodies all the passion and motoring that seems to embrace the whole of Italy. Honda Civic Type R. If the competition was only about driver involvement, outstanding road grip, and engine charisma, this could be an out-and-out winner. Hyundai Kona. It's extremely well-built in typical Hyundai fashion. Lexus ES. You get a lot of car for your money here in terms of size. Mercedes-Benz A-Class. This car surprised with its smooth surface grip levels. Mitsubishi Pajero Sport. It is masterful in extreme off-road conditions. It is a very well-built, mellow SUV on the road. Nissan Micra. Its styling is light years ahead and beyond its predecessor and has an extremely sophisticated interior. Porsche Cayenne. Drive this car around Kyalami and you will be stunned at how such a large SUV can stop, corner, and accelerate. Renault Duster. This is an extremely competent, user-friendly, family SUV. Suzuki Jimny. This is probably the most specialized finalist ever to make it to a Car of the Year competition. Suzuki Swift is the car that meets the Car of the Year's affordability criteria the best. Volvo XC40. We realized once again why it won the European Car of the Year title in 2018. Ladies and gentlemen, a massive round of applause for the 12 finalists in this year's AutoTrader South African Car of the Year competition for 2019. Now, I would like to welcome on stage Mr. Ruben van Niekerk, chairman of the South African Guild of Motoring Journalists. A round of applause, please.
Honoured guests, welcome to the announcement of our winners in the prestigious 2019 AutoTrader South African Car of the Year competition that is being live streamed from here. A special thank you to Roger McCleary, Michelle Walk, Carl Weppener, Viviana Tassen, Winter Murdoch, Jason Wissey, Sean Nurse, and Stuart Johnson from the Guild, and also to Bernie Halberg. A special thank you also to George Minnie, Angela Lynch, Tyrone Woods, Julia Serrao, and Bridget van Eden from AutoTrader. We're also delighted to have the Penta Motor Group here, and so many key role players from the car industry tonight. Working with the talented Michelle Lewis and Nikki Channels from Say Your Say ZA, who assists with our AutoTrader Coach PR has been a great learning curve in teamwork. A first, by the way, as we have never had PR specialists involved in the South African Car of the Year. A big welcome to Robin Emsley, our co-founder from Wilderness. On 29 December 1962, this 20-year-old with more hair than now, alongside Barry Curtis and a few other media rebels, founded the South African Guild of Motoring Journalists in a pub in East London after a race. Of course, I wondered about his hair, whether he had more hair than a beetle. Apparently not. Our young, spirited journalists of the day felt that media did not enjoy enough support from the industry in their effort to serve the audience, the motoring enthusiastic public. This was a key moment in motoring media history in South Africa, as it laid the foundation for far more formalized interaction with all the role players in the sharing of information with the public. These pioneers had laid our modern foundation of a symbiotic relationship between PRs, motoring media, and influencers. In 1986, the South African Guild of Motoring Journalists embarked on a new motoring competition that became respected as the Oscars of the South African car industry over the decades. The South African Car of the Year competition needed an objective and independent platform to evaluate the most cutting-edge new cars in South Africa. Obviously, it was necessary to form a large, influential and independent jury in order to establish international credibility. Over the decades, the South African Car of the Year competition earned recognition as one of the most credible motoring competitions in the world. Globally, it's probably the only one where testing days and a track day would be a standard requirement before an expert jury exceeding 22 jurors who would cast their final votes. This number is deemed to be the minimum required in order to obtain statistical significance. Consequently, our jury always numbers more than 22. During the past 11 years, we've gradually managed to achieve a smaller standard deviation by having a more highly trained jury. This success formula remains based on having a jury that spends 2 days as trainees, 2 years as trainees, and at least 5 years as members of the Guild of Motoring Journalists. Lifestyle media have been welcomed as jurors since 2009, and I became one of the first lifestyle jurors in this program. Last year, the Guild's constitution was amended to allow a new level of membership, namely affiliates, that embraces new media. History was made in September 2018, when AutoTrader became the first new headline sponsor in 34 years. More history was made when we worked closely with a highly motivated AutoTrader team, who engineered the complex technical process of launching the public vote for the first time in the 2019 AutoTrader South African Car of the Year competition. It was fascinating to play a role in this dynamic new process. And contrary to popular belief, the public did not vote that differently from full members. In fact, 80% plus correlation and votes reaching 55,000 exceeded our wildest dreams. Nobody anticipated such a close correlation or such a massive public response either. The aspirational public tended to vote slightly less conservatively than the jury, and it was marvelous to gain such valuable marketing insight, backed by thousands of voters. This year, we introduced category winners for the first time, as well as automated scoring on value and relevance, which created balance between subjectivity and objectivity. These changes represent a quantum leap in the South African Car of the Year competition. Alongside automated scoring and an independently endorsed, statistically sound scoring system that was introduced 4 years ago, these progressive changes ensure that the AutoTrader South African Car of the Year competition remains the benchmark for decades into the future. Our standards are exceptionally high, and most of our jury have more than 5 years of experience. Stuart Johnson and Colin Wendell are the only two jurors since inception who are still active as jurors, while the 29-year record for serving consecutively goes to Bobby Cheatham. The Guild grew from a tiny band of rebels to a large organization where our philosophy remains about excellence professionalism, and skills transfer. Our burning passion is to do what we do well. Neither profit nor sponsor pressure plays any role in how we choose our winners. Objectivity will be nurtured in our intense annual quest to find the most deserving winners in the South African Car of the Year competition. We can only wish that we have not only met, but exceeded the dreams of the young Robin Emsley, Barry Curtis, and the Rebels from 1962. Thank you. George, Minnie from AutoTrader, would you mind joining us, please?
All right. Thank you so much, Ruben. Let's give him a round of applause, please. Right, AutoTrader, a name South Africans have known for almost 27 years. 16 April 1992 marked the assembly line inception of the coffee table favorite magazine for browsers, dreamers, and researchers alike. At some point, printers had difficulties binding the almost 1,000 pages we printed weekly. Receiving adverts on Monday night and working tirelessly to get the publication on retail shelves by Thursday morning. A gear shift in 2007 brought the website autotrader.co.za and the smartphone application to the hands of South Africans. 2017 saw the end of the AutoTrader print publication and the ignition of the fully digital and online company, who soon began celebrating over 70 million site visitors each year. From about 1.4 million magazines sold annually over 10 years ago, to over 70 million visits each year, a well-steered print-to-digital evolution was undertaken. A business that is now 20 times bigger in its digital world than it was in print. Now it gives me great pleasure to now introduce the captain of this massive landliner, the driving force between the transition from old to new, the CEO of AutoTrader South Africa, George Meany.
Thank you, Neebs, and welcome everybody, and thank you for coming this evening. I'd like to start by reciting a famous Benjamin Franklin saying. There are only two certain things in life, and you know what they are. The one is death, and the other one is taxes. Well, I'd like to add a third, and that third one is change. Nothing stays the same. Change is constant. And does anybody remember the magazine back in 1992? Our very first magazine. It cost just 50 cents and was 24 pages thick. The number of late nights it would have taken to fill that magazine, I'm sure many of you in this room would attest to. Deadlines. To make sure that they were going to print perfectly for this first deadline. That was the very first hard week for AutoTrader. And after that, we've had many, many more. But it's been worth it. Because AutoTrader was like a telephone book. I'm sure you remember it in every waiting room. It was the place where millions of South Africans had their dream of a new car come true. And it has since become a brand entrenched in the memory of millions of people in South Africa. But let's be frank. We knew internally that things were changing. We were faced with a very, very real threat. Looking at overseas trends, it was obvious that our entire business, by now printing 1,000 pages a week plus, was not going to survive the coming digital wave. So we had to respond. If we didn't, we simply wouldn't be here tonight. And while change is scary, change is necessary. And that's what saved us. While businesses folded around us, we learned the necessity of staying creative to stay ahead. We learned the necessity of being willing to change. Since our announcement as being the headline sponsor of this Car of the Year, I've heard many reactions, some negative, but mostly positive. And the thread running through them all, a quieter thread, is what we've listened to. And that is the question, why? Why AutoTrader? Why Car of the Year? Well, for us, the answer is very obvious. This awards body is world-renowned, with expert jury members judging the best car that this country has to offer. But more importantly, the question is not why. The question is, why not? And the Guild wanted the same things as what we did. Change. Together. This year, the consumer vote has been added to the competition, making tonight's winning brands even more deserving, even more relevant, and even more real. The new categories have also been introduced, adding to the importance of this award as they better reflect consumer interest. Car of the Year has shown not only to be the most credible, but now also the most relevant Car of the Year competition in South Africa because of the willingness to change. So for us, however, it's been the journey. We've gotten to go on with all of you. We get to innovate and change the game together. We get to delight our customers together. And we get to build deeper relationships together. We're grateful to be a part of all of this with you. And we thank you. Thank you to the Guild for trusting us with your brand. This is your baby. You created it. We've built a good foundation together in a very, very short space of time. And we look forward to a long and mutually beneficial relationship together. And thank you to the OEMs. Without you, none of this is possible. Thank you for taking part. Thank you for your time. And thank you for your investment. But most of all, thank you for your involvement in this process. Then thank you to Penta. We share a vision. And this is just the beginning of our road together. Thank you for being involved. Thank you to the jury members. Your time is valuable. We know this. And we're grateful that you chose this, your time, to spend with us. Like many people in this room, you spend a lot of your time away from your family and friends, traveling to attend events and to test cars. We know that this is a labor of love for many of you. Finally, thank you to my team. What an event. What a journey that we've come on together over the last number of months. Thank you for the long hours and the laughs. It's all been worth it. But always remember, change is scary, change is necessary, but change is constant.
Thank you very much, George Meany, for those inspirational words. Now, journalism. What is it? The activity or profession of writing for newspapers, magazines, or news websites, or preparing news to be broadcast. That's the Google definition. That's how we generally define it nowadays. Other definitions tend to break down the word to an origin of journal, a daily record of news and events of a personal nature, a diary. Another definition from Google. Wikipedia's history of journalism talks about word of mouth being the first form of journalism, where merchants, sailors, and travelers would share their stories of their journeys with customers, players, which were what we would call today's actors, or the general public. It goes on to say that ancient scribes then recorded these stories into their journals. Journalists, perhaps? Journalist, a person who writes for magazines, newspapers, or news websites, or prepares news to be broadcast. Now, I'll give you three guesses where I got that definition from. Now, when I see or hear the word journalism, I think storytellers. Spanning back to the beginning of time where perhaps the first scoop was drawn with a mere finger on a patch of sand. But sand gets washed away, blown by the wind, trampled on, earthquake shook, etc. Nature. Maybe a stone on the bark of a tree. Perhaps. But trees get cut down and used for many different things, like lavatories. Or they just grow and die. The natural order. Cave paintings seem to stand the test of time. The great hunting tale told of old. A scoop within the scooped rock. Now man went back to trees when written words grew in meaning or worth. scribing on ancient papyrus, printing stories using wood blocks, and eventually using trees themselves to make paper. Extra, extra, read all about it. Yeah? Now, the first fashion magazine to be published came from France in the 1600s. I guess that's why the biggest fashion week is in Paris. Now, as technology continued to grow, it became impossible for word of mouth to die as a form of journalism, as radio and television would give it the best platforms for it to thrive. The stories couldn't be limited only to the ones that could read. Now, with smart mobile devices, we've got it all in the palm of our hands. Through those glass windows, internet content to your heart's content. And we owe it mostly to the journalists that have journeyed far and wide, even locally, to bring us the stories we gossip about from the pages of their journals. Now, journalism has survived all sorts of trials and tribulations, transitions and transformations, just to give the people truth-based stories and news through the power of press freedom. Now, up until 1984, where the typewriter was no longer or hardly in use, journalists would go through head-busting battles to win the war on deadlines. The sometimes therapeutic clatter of the typewriter keys soon turned into rapid gunfire during the rush. Lack of the backspace key meant absolute focus with every stroke. And of course, the fear of the dreaded paper jam. Ding, ding, ding. Now, those writing from home or on the road had to hand in their stories via post or fax. From dictaphones to smartphones, typewriters to computers, laptops, and tablets, things are now easier and more in control. And information is now just a touch away. Almost everything happens online now. Like, for example, the launch of the Rolls-Royce Cullinan, the brand's first SUV, was entirely online. While on cars, the journalism around them also changed over the years, from focusing mostly on things like power steering, ABS braking in the 1980s, we are now more interested in the digital features and their innovations. We read about autonomous driving, connectivity, the green revolution, etc. From a limited range of vehicles to test drive around the 1990s due to import duties sitting between 115 and 125% to now being spoiled for choice when duties dropped to around 25%. Forever chasing the stories and the deadlines, I think the hourglass is the perfect metaphor for the journalists. The sand of old, the wood in its many different uses, and the glass screens we touch today. They, together, keep track of all the ages capturing the evolution of journalism. Dear journalists, we thank you for your journals. Now, I would like to welcome on stage the meanest man of them all. Welcome back, George Meany, who will be handing over a gift on behalf of AutoTrader for all the juries, the esteemed jurors we have. George, how about you tell us more about these amazing gifts?
I will indeed. Well, Neeps, to thank our jurors and to help keep them supercharged on their deadlines that we spoke about a little bit earlier, we're giving them complimentary access to the slow lounges in all major airports in South Africa and Vita E coffee vouchers to keep their tanks full.
Wow, that is amazing. A round of applause. So this is for the jurors and me. Right.
No.
Okay. Fine. It's cool. Carry on. Now, if I could ask the following people to join us on stage, please, to receive your gift courtesy of AutoTrader. Now, please enter, get your gift, and stand right there on our left so that we can get a group photo thereafter. Now, here are the list of names. Carl Wepener, Colin Wendell, Derek Watts, Dirk Galkowitz, Gert Smit, Ferdy De Vos, Hannes Visser, Janine Lee van der Post, Jeanette Kok Kritzinger, Justice Fasahi, Mabuyane Gekana, Pritesh Ruthan, Ruben van Iken, Sean Nurse, and last but not least, Stuart Johnson, Lauren Smith, and Leanna Raiders. Let's give them a round of applause as they make their way up to the stage. Whoa. For the groupie. Thank you guys, please make your way back to your seats. Let's give them another round of applause, these awesome jury members. Thank you very much, guys. We appreciate your hard work. Ladies and gentlemen, now that concludes part one of this evening's journey. For those of you watching from home, don't go too far. We'll be resuming in 40 minutes with the 2019 AutoTrader South African Car of the Year competition. Now, are the cameras off? All right. Now, the rest of you left with me here. Dinner will be shortly served. Don't worry about that. Now a lot of people are getting worried. Dinner will be served shortly. Please feel free to explore our decadent harvest tables and get ready for round two of the AutoTrader South African Car of the Year competition. Please enjoy and catch you later. Woo! Yes, indeedy. Don't be greedy. Feed the needy. Welcome back to the 2019 AutoTrader South African Car of the Year competition. We are so glad that you could join us as we move on to the second part of the evening. Now, the process to get to this point of the competition is long and a tedious task. Many hours spent compiling the numbers to ensure that every scoring factor is considered and true. Innovations in the 2019 competition include the introduction of individual categories alongside one overall winner and the all-important inclusion of the consumer vote made possible by AutoTrader's in-market car shopper audience. We received over 55,000 consumer votes this year. A job not for the faint-hearted. These innovations show that the evolution of the competition and the contribution towards the quest of perfection is what we're doing. All right. To present the first category this evening, I would like to call on jury member Sean Nurse and special guest Tamsin Pepper. Pepper's racing pedigree is long and illustrious. At just 28, she boasts a string of national championship wins, rookie championship wins, and most recently, she secured a place in the next round of the W Series, the new European-based single-seater racing series for female drivers. Let's give them a round of applause.
Hello. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And what an honor it is to stand up here in front of you all and with a seasoned professional. Tasman, you look stunning this evening.
Thank you, Sean. It is indeed an honor. Tonight, we'll be presenting the Urban Compact category.
These are the type of cars that you could use as a runaround and that can fit in a tight parking space. And of course, let's not forget that they're also light on fuel and quite affordable. Let's have a look at the nominees.
In the Urban Compact category, the nominees are the Suzuki Swift, the Nissan Micra,
oh, sorry, mark you. Ladies and gentlemen, Raise your glasses for the winner. It's a bit harder to open than I thought.
Industrial grade.
And the winner is Suzuki Swift.
Any member of the Suzuki Swift team, please come up and receive your trophy. All right, they're coming. Congratulations to Suzuki Swift. Now, to present our second category this evening, I would like to call on jury member Janine van der Post and a racing legend, a 20-time Formula One driving South African racing legend, having driven at the highest level between 1974 and 1977. I can attest to that. I was there for every race. In his two spells in domestic racing, he dominated the local championship, winning 49 races and equaling John Love and Charlton's tally of 6 championships. None other than Mr. Ian Schachter. Round of applause.
Hi.
Good evening, everyone. We are delighted we could join you here this evening.
Tonight we'll be presenting the family sedan and hatch category. This is a category that drew 2 contenders, and both of them happen to be hatches.
Let's have a look at the nominees.
In the family sedan hatch category, the nominees are the Mercedes-Benz A-Class and the Honda Civic Type R.
And the winner is the Mercedes-Benz A-Class.
That's it.
All right, let's have the winners of this category, please, up here. Claim your prize. Is anyone coming up on behalf of the winners? Are they coming? There you go. Let's give them a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Another round of applause. Congratulations. Now, to present our third category this evening, I would like to call on stage a motoring specialist that hosts a weekly motoring slot on Metro FM every Saturday and on Motwedi FM on Tuesdays. Jury member Mabuya Nekekane. And to join him in presenting the next award, a journalist with over 25 years of experience, a core part of South African television journalism and anchoring for the most of that time. Most notably for presenting and anchoring the primetime record-charting show, Carte Blanche, Mr. Derek Watts. Let's give them a round of applause.
Neats, thank you very much for that wonderful introduction. I believed some of it. My relatives call me Dex, so we may be related.
Indeed.
So, Derek and I are going to try and present something. What is it called?
It is called the Leisure Crossover Category.
Category, yes.
And I think things got a bit more competitive in this category this year, where we had finalists across a broad pricing spectrum. So let's have a look at the contenders.
In the Leisure Crossover Category, the nominees are the Alfa Romeo Stelvio, the Hyundai Kona, the Porsche Cayenne, the Renault Duster, and the Volvo XC40.
And the winner is Porsche Cayenne. Woo!
And we have representatives of the Porsche Cayenne. Please come up on stage. There we go. Let's give them a round of applause. Congratulations, guys. Let's give them another round of applause. And now to present our fourth award this evening, I'd like to welcome AutoTrader's digital marketing specialist. She's been with the brand for almost 14 years and leads the talented team who have built campaigns delivering over 130 million impressions for this year's AutoTrader South African Car of the Year competition. Marketing Director of AutoTrader, Angelique Lynch. Joining Angie is a jury member who has earned the right to be called one of the doyens of the motoring industry. He started as a freelance journalist in 1963, concentrating on motoring industry, motorcycling, and motorsport. Now, he has broadcasted on radio since 1969. A member of the SAGMJ for the last 26 years and has been awarded with fellow membership in June 2014 and is currently the president, Mr. Roger McCleary. Let's give them a round of applause.
You were told to say that.
I promise I wrote this all myself.
I can see that.
And you're looking at least 20 years younger than the last time
that's
I saw
girl.
You.
That's my girl. Thanks, Angie. Okay. And the category is, just before we get to, I just want to put my little note in there about thanking AutoTrader. They've been a most energetic, great sponsor. They're hands-on. They've got a whole team behind it. And I must say this venue, when we started Huddle Park, it would have been good enough because we could have all parked in and found out the winner. But to come here and see the surprise, it is stunning. I think we must give them a big hand for that. Well done. That really is very fair. And a big thanks. We hope we have a long association with you. It certainly started well with George and Angie and the whole team, Michelle and everybody else in the team, and Nikki. It's just a great team of people. You're really hands-on, and it's nice to be part of it. It's opened up a whole lot of things. So well done. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Roger, for those really, really kind words. The lifestyle utility category proved to be a really interesting one, combining lifestyle attributes with a degree of usefulness that will leave your neighbor green with envy. Let's take a look at this year's nominees.
In the lifestyle utility category, the nominees are the Mitsubishi Pajero Sport and and a Suzuki Jimny.
Tell you. I thought everybody memorized their speeches. I got an auto cue here, man. I can see it all in front of me. Good Lord, it's easy. Well done, Suzuki Jimny.
Can we please have the representatives of Suzuki Jimny? And there they are. Let's give them a round of applause. Thank you, guys. Let's give them another round of applause. Congratulations. And now, I would like to call on a very special guest, Letsego Zulu, wife of the late Gugu Zulu. Letsego is here because we believe it's important to keep alive the memories of great South Africans. And Letsego has been doing this for Gugu with her trip to Kili last year. We want to continue with this tradition and would like to thank SA Hall of Fame for putting on display a piece of his memorabilia at Sun City. Letsego, please join me on stage. Now, Gugu was an inspiration to many, and this display will help educate and inspire the thousands of visitors, including school children, who pass through its facilities. And the helmet will be on display here tonight for you to have a look at as well. Letsego. Letsego, thank you for joining us, and we are honored to have you here.
Thank you so much for having me, Nibs. Good evening, everyone.
Now, while we have you on stage, I'd like to ask a regular contributor of the Ignition TV, recently appointed editor of Driven Magazine at TCB Media, and Car of the Year jury member for the last 8 years, Lerato Matebisa. Please join us on stage to announce the final category, the premium sedan category.
Hello, Lerato.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Neeps. This is a traditional category for cars that are drop-dead desirable, created for well-heeled amongst us. It follows the tried and tested three-box style format of a bonnet, a passenger compartment, and a boot.
And as luck would have it, there was only one nominee in this category. However, it was not yet decided if we would crown them as premium sedan category winners for 2019. Let's take a look and see what happened. Let's take a look and see what happened.
And the winner is the Lexus ES 250.
In the premium sedan category, with only one nominee,
congratulations, guys. Now, let's have a big round of applause for the five category winners, jurors, and special guests. Thanks to you all. Ladies and gentlemen, do not go anywhere. Stay in those seats of yours as we will take time to charge your glasses for you. Now, that includes all of you watching at home, you know, take in the comforts of your home. Make sure that you grab a glass of celebratory champagne as we're about to reveal the winner of the 2019 AutoTrader South African Car of the Year competition. Stay with us. Ladies and gentlemen, please stay seated and do not leave. Thank you, Mr. Fire Dancer. That was scary. Where's the health and safety guy? Well, folks, the time has come for the main event. The reason we are all here to crown the top three in the 2019 AutoTrader South African Car of the Year competition. Please, can I have Mr. Carl Wippener, Ruben van Niekerk, and George Meany to join me on stage to present these awards. Let's give them a round of applause. And now, in third position, the award goes to the Volvo XC40. Let's give them a round of applause. Let's give them another round of applause. And in second position, the award goes to the Porsche Cayenne. Let's give them a round of applause. Have the representatives, of course. There we go. Look at that smile. A round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. All right, let's give them a round of applause. Congratulations, guys. And now, the moment we've all been waiting for. It's time to reveal the AutoTrader South African Car of the Year for 2019. Let's just move out the way, gentlemen, and let's show these people the amazement. Come on, Sadie, and collect your prize, Mercedes. finishing there.
Just a little water.
Congratulations to all the winners of this evening. And thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen, for joining us. For joining us tonight here, all the way from the comfort of your home. Thank you to our YouTube viewers who watched us from at AutoTrader SA. Thank you for being here with us. We have crowned the winner of this year's 2019 Car of the Year Awards. Powered by AutoTrader South Africa. Let's give them a round of applause. Thank you and good night. Bye-bye, YouTube. All right, thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and a very well done to all the winners. Drive safe. Otherwise, you can stay with us and have a great time in this wonderful venue of Ships and Gardens. Thank you for having me. You guys have been awesome. Peace.
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. Off from my city, off from my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Yeah.
do battle, perform for a princess. But tonight, I can make it my queen and make love to you endless. It's insane the way the name growing, money keep flowing. Hustlers moving silent, so I'm tiptoeing. So keep blowing, I got it locked up like Lindsay Lohan. Put it on my life, baby. I'm gonna get you right, baby. Can't promise tomorrow, but I promise tonight. Guys.